Good morning, students. Like yesterday, we have studied simple past tense. Today, we will take the same topic ahead and will learn the rules of past continuous tense and changing of affirmative sentences of past continuous tense into negative, interrogative, and negative interrogative sentences. By the end of this video, the child will be able to identify past continuous tense and will be able to change affirmative sentences of past continuous tense into negative, interrogative, and negative interrogative sentences. Now, past continuous tense expresses an action begun and continuing in the past, but its time limit is not known. Now let us see the rule of past continuous tense from the mapping. The rule of past continuous tense for positive or affirmative sentences is was, were, plus present form of verb plus ing. Now let us take an example. Ria was watching television. Who Ria? So subject. Was is the helping verb. Watching is present form of verb plus ing. Watch television. So object. Always remember, the helping verbs used in past continuous tense are was and were. Now, where to use them? With all the singular subjects, we use was. For example, with Sia, Raj, the boy, the girl, he, she, it, I, we always use was. Now let us take few examples. Sia dash with her doll and the verb is play. Who Sia? So subject. As the subject is singular, we will use was. Play will be changed to present form of verb plus ing, that is playing. So the answer is Sia was playing with her doll. The boy dashed to the zoo and the verb is go. Who the boy? So subject. As the subject is singular, we will use was. Go will change to present form of verb plus ing, that is going. So the answer is the boy was going to the zoo. She dash food. Who she? So subject. As it is a singular subject, we will use was. Make will change to present form of verb plus ing, that is making. So the answer is she was making food. Now with all the plural subjects, we always use were. For example, with the boys, the girls, the men, they, we always use were. Now let us see few examples. The boys dash food. Who the boys? Is so subject. As it is a plural subject, we will use were. Here the verb eat will change to present form of verb plus ing, that is eating. So the answer is the boys were eating food. They dash a song and the verb is sing. Who they? So subject. As it is a plural subject, we will use were. Sing will change to present form of verb plus ing, that is singing. So the answer is they were singing a song. The girls dash on the stage and the verb is dance. Who the girls? So subject. As the subject is plural, we will use were. Dance will change to present form of verb plus ing, that is dancing. So the answer is the girls were dancing on the stage. Now here is an exception to with you. Though you is used with one person, we will always use were. Now let us see few examples. You dash an ice cream and the verb is eat. Who you? So subject. With you we will always use were. Eat will change to present form of verb plus ing, that is eating. So the answer is you were eating an ice cream. You dash to the zoo and the verb is go. Who, you, so subject. With you, we will always use verb. Go will change to present form of verb plus ing, that is going. So the answer is you were going to the zoo. You dash with your friends and the verb is play. Who, you, so subject. As I have already told, with you, we will always use verb. Play will change to present form of verb plus ing, that is playing. So the answer is you were playing with your friends. Now let us see the rule of past continuous tense from the mapping for negative sentences. The rule is was, were plus not plus present form of verb plus ing. Always remember, when we have to change an affirmative sentence to a negative sentence, we will always use not. And not is always used with the helping verb. Now let us see few examples. First, we have to identify all the helping verbs. In the first sentence, the helping verb is was. In the second sentence, the helping verb is was. In the third sentence, the helping verb is were. In the fourth sentence, the helping verb is were. Now, Ria was watching television. We have to add not to make it negative, and not will be added with the helping verb. So the answer is Ria was not watching television. I was playing cricket. We have to add not, and not will be used with the helping verb. So the answer is I was not playing cricket. The girls were singing a song. We have to add not to make it negative, and not will be added with the helping verb. So the answer is the girls were not singing a song. You were going to the market. We have to add not, and not is always used with helping verbs. So the answer is you were not going to the market. Now we will see the rule of past continuous tense for interrogative sentences. The rule is was, were plus subject plus present form of verb plus ing plus object at the end question mark. Now, whenever we have to change an affirmative sentence into interrogative sentence, the helping verb comes before the noun or pronoun, and at the end we have to use a question mark. Now let us see few examples. First, we have to identify all the helping verbs. So the helping verb in the first sentence is was. The helping verb in the second sentence is were. The helping verb in the third sentence is was. Now, Ria was watching television. To change a sentence into interrogative, we have to bring the helping verb before the noun or pronoun. So was will be bought before the noun Ria. So the answer is was Ria watching television question mark. The girls were singing a song. What is the helping verb? We will bring it before the noun the girls. So the answer is were the girls singing a song question mark. I was playing cricket. Was is the helping verb. We will bring the helping verb before the pronoun I. So the answer is was I playing cricket question mark. Now let us see the rule of past continuous tense for negative interrogative sentences. The rule is was were plus subject plus not plus present form of verb plus ing plus object question mark. Now always remember, to change an affirmative sentence into negative interrogative, first we have to change the sentence into negative. That means not will be used with the helping verb. Now, helping verb will come before the noun or pronoun. That means we have to make it interrogative, and at the end we have to put a question mark. Now let us see an example. Ria was watching television is an affirmative sentence. First, we have to pick up helping verb. Was is the helping verb. To make it negative, we have to add not with the helping verb. So the answer is, Riya was not watching television. Now to make it into negative interrogative, we have to bring the helping verb was before the noun Riya. So the answer is, was Riya not watching television? ? Now let us see few more examples to make the concept more clear. The boys were playing football is an affirmative sentence. Were is the helping verb. To make it negative, we have to add not with the helping verb. So the answer is, the boys were not playing football. To make it negative interrogative, we have to bring the helping verb were before the noun the boys. So the answer is, were the boys not playing football? ? You were eating an ice cream is an affirmative sentence where were is the helping verb. To make it negative, we have to add not with the helping verb. So the answer is, you were not eating an ice cream. To make it negative interrogative, we have to bring the helping verb were before the pronoun you. So the answer is, were you not eating an ice cream? ? Now, very often, the simple past and past continuous tense are used together. It suggests that one activity was continuing when the other took place. Now, we use a simple past to denote the action happened in the middle of a longer action denoted by past continuous tense. For example, when my friend arrived, I was playing cricket. Here, we use past continuous tense to refer to the longer background action and simple past tense to refer to the shorter action that has happened in the middle. Now, always remember, with the activity continuing, we will use past continuous tense. And with the activity that took place in the middle of a longer activity or in between, we will use simple past tense. Now, let us see few more examples to make our concept more clear. When he ran out, it was raining hard. Here, we use past continuous tense to refer to the longer period of action and simple past tense to refer to the shorter action that had happened in the middle, which means it was raining hard is a longer background action and when he ran out is a shorter action that had happened in the middle. When I visited his home, he was sleeping soundly. Here, past continuous tense refers to the longer background action and simple past tense refers to the shorter action that had happened in the middle, which means he was sleeping soundly is a longer background action, while when I visited his home is a shorter action that had happened in the middle. So the point to remember is, with the longer background action, we will always use past continuous tense, or with the activity continuing, we will always use past continuous tense. And with the shorter background action, which has happened in the middle, we will use simple past tense. Now, following these rules, do related exercises of chapter 11, verbs expressing the past from your basic English grammar and composition book 7. Thank you.